So again, my name is Jim Holbert. I'm the pre-award manager for Corey, responsible for our merit review process. So someone in the audience earlier said that PCORI is moving at the speed of light, and we certainly are. In the past 8 months, we have done three merit reviews. We've completed our first full year of merit reviews in a span of 8 months. That is very, very fast. And one of the things that PCORI is a little different, and Sue mentioned it earlier, is that we include patients throughout all phases of our research. And part of that is, during merit review, evaluating those proposals. A little bit about our reviewers. Half of all of our reviewers are patients and other stakeholders. So people from advocacy organizations, patients themselves, caregivers, people that are payers, come from industry, clinicians. And these people are diverse in respect to their previous experience doing peer review, their expertise and professions, their affiliations or their advocacy groups, age and demographics. Right now, all 50 states are covered by our reviewers, and that's a big swath of the country there, and it's quite representative of the entire population. A little bit about numbers. So again, 8 months. We started cycle one when Anne first came on board. We had 50 patients and stakeholder reviewers part of our program. Last cycle, we had 100, so we've doubled over at least one full cycle. We recognized early on that oftentimes patients and other stakeholders are not part of the peer review process. This is new to them, but they need help navigating this environment. So we developed a mentorship program. So a little bit about our speed. Our first cycle was in November of 2012. In January of 2013, right after the holiday, we held our first mentorship training. We looked at some of the reviewers that we have in the first inaugural cycle and recognized that they had an ability to mentor others. So we brought 8 people to PCORI's offices right after the start of the new year because we recognized that these reviewers needed more peer-to-peer guidance, that they needed a deeper level of assistance than that we currently provided in the model. They needed more hands-on support, and that we also wanted to build a community of reviewers, and these mentors would help with that process. So the mentors. So these mentors, we tasked them with a big undertaking. These were 8 people, first time ever doing this. We asked them to help us develop training. They, as having gone through the reviewer process, being new to the merit review process, would best know the type of training that other patients and stakeholders need to have. We asked them to provide ongoing support. So over 3 months, they were to make phone calls, emails, be available on the weekend to their mentees. They were to review all of the critiques that came in by their mentees, looking to ensure that those critiques were well written, that they were defensible in front of peer review, that they were strong. We also asked them to mentor people at the peer review process, to sit with them if they saw that they were being really quiet during merit review, maybe pull them aside at break and help them feel more comfortable and confident speaking in front of the panel. We also asked them to identify the strongest of the patients and stakeholder reviewers to become the next cycle of mentors. And we also asked them to evaluate our reviewers. What can we do better? Where are we still having those gaps? How can we best prepare the reviewers for the next cycle? And then every week, they have a touch base with PCORI. So we do a conference call with all of our mentors during merit review, and we find out what's going well, what's not going so well, just kind of a status check of our reviewers. So the outcomes. What we're finding is that now by having this program, we're seeing stronger written critiques. Our mentors are able to help these mentees write their critiques, understand the application, and help them draw out the strengths and the weaknesses of the application and write that strong critique. We find that our reviewers are more vocal during merit review. They feel more comfortable sitting at a panel full of physicians and scientists that are really leaders in their field and knowing that they have an equal voice, and if anything, their voice may be even stronger than that of some of the scientists. That they articulate their viewpoints more clearly. We're also seeing these lasting relationships. We're building this community. We're using social media in a very unique way where these patient and stakeholder reviewers can interact with one another, share ideas. They post, they do blogs together, they find rides to the airport. they sit together at Merit Review at dinner, and they're starting to get to know each other and start to share a little bit about their organizations and where they come from. And then they're also transferring knowledge. And then I just want to point out, here's a quote from one of the mentors, from one of the mentees, saying the mentors were extremely helpful. Being able to discuss situations and examples with the mentor helped me to better the review proposals. Again, these people are novice. They've never done this with some of them. And being able to lean on someone who's been there and done that and can give them tips of the trade has really made them feel more comfortable and confident. And that's exactly what we want of our merit review program. So I'm now at 5 minutes and 5 slides.
Woo, thank you.
Thank you.